Reinstalled Seattle Asian Art Museum. It's set to reopen this weekend, but before it does, Ellen Taylor is there with a first look inside. Mm-hmm. Good morning, Ellen.
Hey, good morning, Bill. My favorite part about museums is when they actually encourage you to touch and play with things. In fact, this is a mask-making set where station where kids can come and play inside the new Seattle Asian Art Museum, like Bill just said, set to reopen this weekend. But I had to ask the professionals really what it is that we're looking at, these beautiful pieces. And Regan Pro, I mean, her last name is Pro, and she's a professional. Let's talk about this piece right here. Beautiful, colorful. What is it that we're looking at right
now? Yeah. So this is an amazing work of art called Flower Ball by a Japanese artist named Takashi Murakami. And what I love, though, is your question is, what are we looking at? Because mm-hmm. this whole space, that's what we're asking people. What do you think you're looking at? What does this mean to you? What does it remind you of? And that's what's most important, right?
Right.
And for this piece, I love how engaging and bright it is, but a lot of people also say it reminds them of emojis.
Yes. Oh, see, and you know what I was thinking? I saw emojis, but then I saw Lisa Frank. It took me back to
that. Totally, yeah. There's a really strong pop culture connection to this, and mm-hmm. I think this whole space is about getting people to come in, look at works of art, and think, sure. How does this matter? What does this remind me of in my own life?
Right.
Why is it important to me?
And there are a lot of things, you know, of course, back from history, too, and if we walk on over this way, like, these pieces, they look like they've been around a while. Okay, now what is it that we're looking at when it comes to these? Are they masks?
These are two masks. So every piece on this wall is a mask. And this whole space is combining the old and the new and different cultures from all around Asia. These two masks are both from Japan, from the Edo period, and they're both demons.
Oh.
So they're used in different ways in performance, but all about telling a story and transforming the wearer.
When we say the Edo period, what dates or what year are we looking at?
Yes. So on the label, I'm going to quote the label so I'm exact, but
yeah.
It says 1603 to 1868.
So it's been a while.
So it's been a while, yeah. So you're in the presence of very new and very old in this space.
Right, and definitely a space where you can create too, because again, over here, the masking and unmasking section, this is made for kids to kind of like interact, right? Or even adults.
Yeah, yes. This is an activity by local artist Ramson Regarde Bustillo, and it's thinking about masks and patterning and expression. And so you get to play with these really fun materials and make your own mask inspired by the mask on the wall.
Yeah, and you know, this is just one of the many sections in this I don't want to call it brand new, because it's what's the right word? Reinvented?
Yeah.
It's the grand reopening of the Seattle Asian Art Museum. It is reopening this weekend. Tickets, though, are sold out. You had like thousands of tickets.
10,000.
A hot
free
ticket.
Tickets.
But it goes back to regular hours on Wednesday, so you will be able to get, you know, to see this for yourself, bring the family along. But you know, all morning long, we're going to actually be hanging out with the experts from the Seattle Asian Art Museum to show you more and give you an inside look at the spot before it reopens to the public later on this weekend. But for right now, guys, I'm going to send it right back on over to you.
Right, Ellen. I love that piece.